I'm going to motivate this with a somewhat silly example, but something that will illustrate many of the properties that are important for cryptographic protocols. As usual, we have Alice and Bob. She's Alice, in case you cannot recognize her. And we have Bob. And Alice and Bob want to decide whose turn it is to charge the robo-dog. If you can't recognize my drawing, this is indeed a robo-dog. But they're not in the same place. They're trying to do this over the telephone. They would normally do this by tossing a coin. So they decide, let's try to toss a coin over the telephone. So this is the first protocol they try. So before describing the protocol, I want to define more carefully what I mean by a protocol. We've actually seen a few already, but I haven't defined what a protocol means. And a protocol involves two or more parties. And what it is, it's a precisely defined sequence of steps. And what each step can involve is some computation, as well as communication. And communication can involve sending data between the parties in the protocol. One way to think of this, it's really the same thing we mean by a procedure in computing. That's something that we can define precisely enough that we can follow it mechanically. But unlike a procedure, which is thought of normally as being followed by one processor, or at least a set of processors controlled by the same party, with a protocol, we have two or more participants involved. So that's why it involves both computation as well as communication. In this class, we're mostly concerned with cryptographic protocols, which means one more thing, that it involves secrets. And the usual reason we want to involve secrets is because we want it to be a security protocol. And a security protocol means that it provides some guarantees, even if some of the participants cheat, and that means they don't follow the steps as specified. So now let's describe our first protocol for this, and this is intended as a cryptographic security protocol. And its participants are two parties, Alice and Bob. The robo-dog that needs charging is certainly involved in this process, but is not an active participant in the protocol. And here are the steps. So the protocol starts by Alice initiating it. So she initiates the protocol by sending Bob a message that says, I'll toss the coin, you call it. Bob calls the coin, and so he sends a message back to Alice that says, I call tails. At this point, Alice tosses the coin, and she responds to Bob that, sorry, with the result of the coin toss. In this case, she'll respond, sorry, it landed on the edge. And it's Bob's turn to walk the robo-dog. So I think I won't insult your intelligence by asking a quiz about whether this protocol works well. If it was a non-security protocol and Alice and Bob trusted each other completely, maybe it would work. Bob can trust Alice to actually toss a coin and tell Bob the real result. If it's a security protocol, it doesn't work at all. If Bob doesn't trust Alice, Alice decides the result, whether Bob wins or loses.